Martino, like I'm from Italy, from Palermo, and I'm currently working at the Research Council in Palermo, I'm a psychologist, and I work in firm collaboration with technician technologists and other psychologists in an institute that is specifically dedicated to education using technologies.
So the study I'm introducing was kind of in the Promise Project. The Promise Project is a research still ongoing, funded by the Italian Ministry of Education, University and Research. The aim of the Promise Project is mainly to activate a national and entire network for raising technological and scientific skills, students' technological and scientific skills, both in school and extra school settings. The project is still carried out through two phases. The first phase was dedicated to the training of 100 teachers in educational robotics in central and in southern Italy, specifically in Palermo. The second phase with other teachers and educators to design by themselves and conduct educational robotics laboratories in private and in the US. We already know, reading the existing literature, that educational robotics within the context of STEM teaching can be effective in enhancing students' learning about those concepts related to the STEM area, to the STEM education, in K-12 education. We also know that educational robotics can support computational thinking learning progression, starting from sequencing skills till the system knowledge. But we also know that current literature is more qualitative, and only with a few quantitative studies are well carried out on the effect of educational robotics on the development of computational thinking skills among primary school students. So, to overcome the gap with the current research. And the robotics laboratory we assess were part of the second phase of the Promise Project. It was carried out by school teachers who have attended the first phase training courses, and in collaboration with researchers of the Institute for Educational Research at the CNR. Each laboratory was organized in four sessions, two hours for each, and for three parallel laboratories across three different classrooms. And it should be noted that each laboratory was supported by students, a high school student from a science or computer science course in Palermo that played the role of coaches, basically. Each laboratory followed the action plan, the following action plan. We introduced the lab educational video kit and the other exploration of hardware components and of the visual programming environments to students, to the elementary school students. After that, we teached the basic programming concept, designing of simple programs, and use of the sensors and the actuators. After that, high school students coached primary school students in construction and programming of new robots solving STEM challenges, so within the context of STEM teaching. So, the aim of the current study is to evaluate the effectiveness of a robotics laboratory supported by the use of the lab educational video for the development of early educational, computational thinking skills in children attending third and fourth grade of primary school. So, children, we use the quasi-experimental post-test-only research design with children attending three different classrooms participating to the intervention group. Children when only 51 students from the original 71 students completed the outcome measures, so were included in the study. Children of three parallel classrooms composed the comparison classes and the comparison group were composed by 32 students completing the outcome measures. So the main measures is our main
after measure was the various tasks. The various tasks are a set of activities originally designed for the International Challenge on Informatics and Computational Thinking. We used the various tasks, 10 various tasks from the 5 kilometers, the Italian kilometers challenge to assess computational thinking, to find an overall measure of a computational thinking skill. And the factors of course on the various tasks were used specifically as a measure of computational thinking. We know that the various tasks were already used as in a previous research for the assessment of children's ability to transfer their computational thinking skill in the solution of problems emulating real life situations. These are the additional, the various tasks. These are the main skills that are promoted or subsumed by the various tasks. They are logically analyzing and organizing data, representing data through abstraction, formal environments, using algorithmic thinking as a way to automatize solution, implementing simple algorithmic procedures. These are the additional measures. We use the measure of academic achievement to compare the comparison intervention group. We also ask children to complete self-record questionnaire on the experience of their experience with the various tasks and their satisfaction with the laboratory. We use the MAN-U test to compare the intervention and the comparison group and independent test to assess the difference, the computational test, between the intervention and the comparison group.
I try to be brief.
So, with regard to the academic performance, we found no significant difference between the between children attending the intervention and the comparison group. So, we may be sure that the intervention and the comparison group are somehow comparable, at least in their academic performance. With regard to the computational thinking test, we found that students participating to the robotic laboratories reported higher total score on the various tasks, obviously, than did those attending only the regular skills curriculum. Students in the intervention group also spent more time in completing the various challenge. So, with regard to a brief discussion concerning our results, it seems that our results adds to the existing literature on the effectiveness of education robotics in computing and promoting computational thinking skills. Specifically, it seems that robotics education may promote the development of computational thinking ability in the solution, as previously said, of real-life problems, of problems emulating somehow real-life situations. We also found that students in the intervention group spent more time in completing the various challenge. We may think that the enhancement of computational thinking skills may somehow explain why children in the intervention group spend more time in completing the challenge while showing a better performance. Maybe the students in the comparison group could have found some tasks more difficult to complete, and thus renouncing to complete the challenge faster than their intervention counterpart. So we may be saying that educational robotics may facilitate the early development of computational thinking skills. So the study may encourage to apply in a systematic way the adoption of educational robotics in primary school education as an engaging and effective tool. The various tasks we used as an outcome measure were able to capture differences in performance between the intervention and the comparison group. However, we have to notice that our sample was really limited, so future studies should address issues related to reliability and validity of the parameters measured by the various tasks using larger sample. Future research should also assess computational thinking skills within different domains of application. So,
Thank you.